Today we're gonna talk all about dates. Not the ones that you go out on with your loved ones, but the ones you eat.
Deeply rooted in Israeli history and culture, the date is a delicious fruit, and Israel is very famous for it. In fact, Israel produces 75% of the entire world production of the medjool dates, which are considered the highest quality dates and are in top demand. But these infamous Israeli dates are actually not Israeli. These dates were imported from California and originate in Morocco, because the real Israeli date trees had been extinct for 2,000 years. But recently, the unbelievable happened. Archaeologists found a 2,000-year-old seed, which after they had successfully germinated, it brought forth the extinct Judean palm tree.
Wow, look how big it is. I can't believe this is it. It's amazing.
In this episode, we will visit the date farms in the Arava Desert, see the Judean date palm that had resurrected from the dead after 2,000 years, and as a bonus, share with you a frozen date recipe that will have you go...
Dates are the staple food of the Judean desert. In fact, they are called the meat of the desert because they're full of energy and they are so good for you and they can fill you up very, very well. Even in the biblical times, they're used as medicine for boils and different types of diseases, and they are mentioned in the Bible a few times. But not only that, they were also the symbol of the Judean kingdom. They found coins, ancient coins, with the palm tree stamped on the coins. But also today we have that on our 10 shekel coin. Look at that. There's a palm on it. So date palm trees are all over Israel, from north to south. But did you know that none of them are original to this land?
That's right. The dates that we have in Israel today are not original to this land. Where do they come from? Morocco. Behind me is a date farm where they grow medjool dates. This is the king of the dates. They're large, they have a lot of meat, they're delicious. That's probably what you would buy. That's what Israel exports to the entire world. But they're not original to this land. They come from Morocco. You see, about half a century ago, Moroccan medjool trees, they died due to disease. So they rescued some of the trees to California. And in the 70s, they brought them to Israel and they found out that if they grow them here in the Arava, in the southeast desert of Israel, they grow to their best potential. But they're not original. What happened to the original Judean date palm? What happened to the date palms that we read about in the Bible? Where is their fruit? We're about to find out.
Lift your legs really high.
So there are two theories why and when Judean trees went extinct. The first one dates all the way back to AD 70. The Romans destroyed the temple and the Judean trees, and since then they've been extinct. The second theory is that they survived all the way until the 14th century, and sometime around the Mamluk period, the climate changed in this region and they died. So the Judean palm trees and the dates went from being the fruit of the region to a joke, where writers who came here after the 14th century, because they couldn't find any Judean palm trees around, it was like a joke. Were they really here? Where are they?
So in the 60s, during the excavations at Masada, archaeologists found an ancient jar, and in that jar were ancient date bits. So they did radiocarbon dating on them, and it estimated the time to the first century. Now, those are really old, ancient date seeds. What do they do with them? They take them to Bar-Ilan University, to a storage room where they lay for 40 years. Until 2005, when Dr. Elaine Soloway took some of those seeds, germinated them, and guess what? One seed sprouted. And they planted it in a kibbutz nearby in the Arava, in kibbutz
Keturah.
Yeah. So let's go there and take a look at that tree.
Let's go. So excited. Yeah. I can't believe it.
So how is it even, so if you're thinking, how is it even possible that a 2,000-year-old seed can become a tree? Right.
It still sprouts.
Yeah, it
after
still
all that time.
It's like that almost doesn't make sense. What is it? Is it a seed cannot die? Is it eternal? Well, it's quite the opposite. A seed wouldn't germinate until it dies. It's actually pretty cool. If you take a seed, it needs to dry, it kind of needs to die, and it stays like this with its DNA and all information inside until water touches it. And then it receives life. So think about it. Water touches it, it receives life. And that's not new, because Leviticus speaks about it, and the symbolism is just incredible. In Leviticus, it says that a seed, if it touches a dead corpse or something unclean, it stays clean. You don't need to do anything with it. Why? Because the seed is dead in itself, right? But if water touches the seed, life enters it, and then it touches an unclean thing like a corpse or something else, then it becomes unclean. And the logic in that is huge, because until life enters the seed, it's still dead. So water must enter the seed for it to receive life. And that's just incredible symbolism here, also with Jesus being the living water that enters us, dead souls. Souls are bound to die eternally. But through Christ, who cleanses us, he is the living water, who drinks from him will never thirst again, he enters us and we receive eternal life.
Wow.
Is Methuselah, the first revived Judean date palm since hundreds and hundreds of years ago. It is amazing. It's called Methuselah after the oldest character in the Bible. It makes sense. And it is standing here tall and beautiful. Now, the only unfortunate thing about this tree is that it's a male tree. What does that mean? It means that it cannot bear fruit, but what it can do, it can pollinate other female trees to bear fruit. So they made a research, and the closest trees to this one by DNA is an Egyptian date palm tree called Hayani date palm. And so that's what they wanted to do, to crossbreed this one to the Egyptian date palm tree to get as close as possible to the date fruit that we had about 2,000 years ago. But there's a better option. Let's go check it out. In 2005, they used more of the seeds found in Masada to germinate them, and three of them worked, and they're right here. We asked, and they don't know yet if they are male or female. They will know when they flower, but I hope so much that one of them is female, because then we can taste original from the times of Jesus dates. Imagine that. Imagine that. How awesome is that? Isn't it exciting?
We should definitely come back here when they flower and check out if we're going to have a new production of Judean dates. We got to return here.
This is incredible because they could restart the Judean crops out of this. Think about it. In a few years, we could have Judean dates. Really, in shops and stuff. Isn't that amazing? It's just mind-baffling.
As promised, now's the time for the secret frozen date recipe. So this is the date that you know, the dried, ripened, medjool date. Very sweet, soft, and that's what you see in the stores. Before it ripens, it looks like this. Now, you don't want to eat this. It's not too sweet. Before it ripens, it's not the best. However, there's another variety. It comes from the honey date palm. And you see, it's more round. Notice oval is the medjool date. And what is special about it is that it's much, much sweeter. So if it ripens, it becomes extremely soft, the skin peels away, and you can just ship it to a different country because it's not gonna look very appealing. It's gonna be all mushed up. But what you can do with them is eat them fresh, just in this form off the tree, because they're so sweet. Before they ripen, they're already sweet enough for consumption. And here's the secret recipe that Rhoda's family shared with me, and I'm gonna share with you. These are best eaten when frozen. So all you have to do is buy them fresh in the store, then go ahead and put them in the freezer. Just freeze them. And in summer, you'll have a delicious summer delight.
Wow. That's just so good. Almost like a sweet mini melon.
I'm going to set a world record on the shortest time it's going to take from asking a woman to have a date with you until the time you actually have a date with her. Are you ready? Are you ready?
I don't know.
All right. Would you have a date with me?
Yeah.
Okay. Here you go. Have a date. Come on, the time is ticking. Faster, faster. We're breaking the world record here. Breaking the world record. There you go.
Yes! Yes! Yeah! You broke a world record. High five.
You're so cheap. That's what it is.
That's 4 shekels back. At least 4 shekels.
So cheap. Ha ha ha!